Jesus, that you said that you'll lead the upwards. God, as we lift this congregation up before you, we asking you to weigh out every need. God, right now, breathe on us this morning. Lord God, we need a brand new touch today. Because the troubles of this world on yesterday got some bogged down this morning. But we believe this morning, Jesus, that you're a hell house driver, that you're a midnight rider. Lord, right now in Jesus' name, touch us today, Lord. Move, Lord, in the midst this morning. Walk the aisles and touch somebody. Heal the sickness. Lord Jesus, we'll give you the praise this morning. And all things, we're going to give you thanks, Lord. We thank you today because God, you brought us here. Thank you, Jesus, for waking us up this morning.
I'm so glad. Hallelujah. I'm Gospel according to St. Luke, the 18th chapter. And we're going to read responsibly verses 1 through 8. Familiar passage of scripture talks about prayer and consistency. Again, the book of St. Luke, 18th chapter. We'll read responsibly verses 1 through 8. If you have that scripture, say amen.
Amen.
And he spake a parable unto them to this end, that men ought always to pray and not to faint. And there was a widow in that city, and she came unto him, saying, Avenge me of mine adversary.
And he would not pour out, but afterward he paid with him in terror.
Troubleth me, I will avenge her, lest by her continual coming she weary me.
And the Lord said, Hear what the unjust judge saith.
And shall not God avenge his own elect, which cry day and night unto him, though he bear long with them? Altogether, the 8th verse.
I tell you that he will avenge them speedily. Nevertheless, when the Son of Man cometh, shall he find faith on the earth.
May the Lord add a blessing to the reading and the hearing of his word.
Good morning, hymn number 93, Blessed Assurance. Mount
mountainous man of Himalayan proportions. The Church of God in Christ thinks the world of Bishop Lindsay. We're here because the presiding bishop told us to come. That Bishop Lindsay was doing something that it takes a saint and a big heart. He's not grafty, he's not greedy. Everybody wants all they can, and he is saying, I want my brethren to go to the right, and I'll go to the left. And I want to divide them, my work. Well, this is almost unheard of. And then share it with another brother. God bless that spirit of liberality. Bishop Ford loves these two men, talks about them constantly. And I've been with Bishop Lenz and Bishop Walker on some momentous occasion. They are both unusually highly intelligent men of an impeccable character, high moral turpitude, redoubtable erudites. That loves the Lord. Will you stand on your feet and receive the presiding bishop of the churches of God?
Without him, dying with a cancer 8 years ago, death all over me. Without him, I wouldn't be here tonight. How many of y'all know it's Jesus? Somebody by the hand. These signs shall follow them that believe. Now everybody know you believe it, that Jesus did die and he rose again. And he's coming back for us. Raise your hands, I know the man. So-called machine Pentecostals. They got your believers, you can only get if you go to a certain hymn, a certain place there. But these signs shall follow him. They shall raise your hand and say, thank God I've got it. Now I want you to try it by faith. Touch somebody now. Time. that's all of you. Mother leans into the state, mother to all of you darlings. You know, I was born just across the river over there somewhere. A place called Clarksdale, Mississippi. All right. Well, we made the president's role. We've been in the White House, and we've been here and been there. But they haven't seen nothing yet. See, some of y'all, you know now, you're getting, you know, important. We got a little worried out, you know, with Bishop Ford just a little bit. Too jumpy. Get a word out, you know, he talks about God too much. Get a word out, you know, he's not trained enough. But honey, I don't want you to train me now, because I got my job on. Know you got the confidence. Know he talks to you. Feel the river water right in your belly right now. Jump on your feet, child. Got it. So closely knitted, and the things we had to do to keep them uplifted. And went to bed, and no boat, remember? John Church hadn't done nothing to me. But I got burdened, thinking about the school in Lexington and the building in Atlanta, Georgia. Start thinking about the ministers of the church, the mission work.
All right, now. Yeah.
And I prayed and went to, got to bed and went to sleep. And just before day in the morning, a car in the vision ran into a lot of children. And these children were screaming, calling for me. Voices of all races. and chirping in my ear, just ringing, crying, and crying voices. He's talking about that distressful. Nobody knows what a preacher, missionary who called of God go through there. You can hear the cries of the children in Africa. You hear them in India. You hear them in the streets all over America. The screams, Bishop Ford, John Ford, Church, Bishop Ford, Church, because calling. And then I came out of that and dropped back off, and then a boy was in distress, was sinking. He cried out, Bishop Ford, Bishop Ford. Then the voice came from him saying, you all have the present generation, unborn generations, now in your hands. Are you going to argue about it first? Are you going to make rules and regulations to stop God? Get out of the way. Get out of the way. Don't you hear the cries in the streets, cries everywhere? Everybody in dope, everybody's in prison, everybody that's going down don't want to be there. But they're helpless. They must reach the place in God where we can cast demons out. Raise your hand and say in the name of Jesus. A song I can't sing, but one day I'll start writing it. Can't you hear the cries shivering in the wounds of being murdered? Mothers leaving their children in the cold, give birth to them and then put them in garbage cans. Here in this great jurisdiction, you're not, you're doing what we used to do with sweet potato vines in Mississippi. Would break one off at the same joint, being cared and transplanted. One bed of potatoes planted. Why does this place right here will give you almost an acre? You can know how. You ought to hear what I'm saying. To a transplant. A lot of men look at me and say, Ford is successful past the jurisdiction. That one congregation I have, over 20 churches been opened up out of it. Get a strong man and send him to another place. Then all of my members belong in that, like with Bishop Moody. I sent him to Evanston. Every member I had lived in Evanston, Illinois, they couldn't come back to me. You got to stay there. He built a great church there. Now he's got one of the greatest churches in the brotherhood. So it didn't hurt me, I'm stronger. Some of y'all don't know. You keep a daughter and $5, you can keep it right in your house. I won't let none of them get married. Five sons and all y'all still.